School reopens on Monday, and I'm here at Deyi Secondary School to find out what they're doing to prevent the spread of the H1N1 virus.
So what can students expect when they return to school on Monday?
They will expect lessons as usual and the added measures of screening at the gate, and they are used to the temperature, daily temperature taking exercise. So for the first week, students will be taking their temperature twice a day, and there will be no morning flag raising assembly. Students will be reporting to the classrooms, and they must declare their travel history as well.
If the student is dishonest about declaring their travel history, how will the school deal with it?
In the event that we suspect a student might have travelled to an affected country and not declaring truthfully, then we will call up the parents and have a one-to-one discussion, face-to-face discussion with the parents. I do hope that all the parents and children will honestly declare, and that will be a real reflection of our education system. So far, I don't have incidents of students who don't declare fully.
So how many students from the school will be given the leave of absence?
To date, with Indonesia and Hong Kong being classified as affected countries, at today's count, we have about 17.
How will the home-based learning option be carried out?
The students are used to our e-learning because since the last 4 years, we have twice a year e-learning lessons. So most of the students already are equipped with PCs and broadband at home. Currently, we have planned the home-based learning timetable already with 5 hours of learning minimum a day. We also envision and anticipate a heavy flow of traffic on the internet and the LMS as well. So we are diverting some of the traffic to other websites and also to blogspots and use some of the YouTube videos, and also possibility of sending hard copies of worksheets and even CDs.
What about for those students who don't have a PC or broadband at home?
So we are looking into possibility of loaning the students some PCs. The other way is to print the hard copies for them. And the teachers will call them up and discuss with them.
So how do you monitor the students' progress since it's a home-based learning and there will not be a teacher there to facilitate things?
So in the home-based timetable, we have plans such that, say, you have a 1 hour, 10 minutes period for each subject a day in blocks of 1 hour, 10 minutes to weave in possibility of them contacting the teacher. So for every lesson that we mounted, there is a helpline for them to contact the subject teacher in charge. There are also avenues for them to email their teacher's question. They can also SMS or they can actually call the hotline. Of course, we also set assignments. Some are quizzes where after reading the e-packages, they can actually answer a short quiz. For the longer assignments like composition writing, they have to mail back to the teachers, and teachers should be able to mark and return within 2 weeks.
Are there plans to scale down CCAs, like to prevent the congregation of students in one area?
For CCAs, for the first week, we'll scale back the CCAs so that they don't come in big groups. They can have smaller groups CCA. So for example, in the uniform groups, we can separate like NCO training and the lower sec new cadets training.
Have you had any feedback from parents about their concerns?
So far, no. Of course, there are some anxious parents who ask whether things like for the graduating classes, if school closure, what's going to happen. So we have informed them there is a home-based learning program up for them. And of course, we are trying to see ways where the students can interact with the teacher via video conferencing.
The Razorism of the day is, when the going gets tough, the tough gets going. The H1N1 flu situation may be getting worse, but the best we can do is to take necessary precautions and get ready to fight the spread of the virus.